sunshine I promised you didn't materialize. That's science for you. I'd like to thank everyone for coming, especially those of you who come from outside of the home counties. Who's here not from the home counties? Fantastic. I've heard we've had people as far as Aberdeen. Where are you? Are you here? Well, it's only been 4 weeks since this started, and it's gone from one idea to 23,000 signatures on a petition, and all of you here today, all because we think that science is vital. I have been credited with starting this movement, but that's not fair at all. A lot has been brewing behind the scenes before I came up with this idea. For example, Evan Harris, who just spoke, he's been urging us for months to get off our arses and do something about it. We've been ignoring him politely because we're scientists and we work in the lab and we're too busy, and I'm guilty of that as well. But when I heard Vince Cable's now infamous speech, something in me just snapped, and I thought, this is ridiculous. They really are thinking of dismantling UK science. Now, I'm not British, in the interest of full disclosure. You might be able to tell. But I came here from America because I think the science is actually better here than it is in the States. And I don't want to have to go back there. So, we're here today for a number of things. We're here to send a message to the gentlemen and ladies in this building, the Treasury, that we think that cutting funding to science will actually backfire, because it is precisely the research we do, the development, the innovation, and the tech that fuels the economy. And if we cut the sector, we will be shooting ourselves in the foot, as Patrick Moore said on our website so prosaically. So, if the economy is flagging, the last thing we want to do is to dismantle scientists and engineers. It makes absolutely no sense. We also are, of course, aware that science is a wonderful thing for society. We cure diseases, we build bridges, we make buildings, we send things into space, we do all these things that make our culture so great. And Britain has done really well. Britain has punched above its weight. Just look at the Nobel laureates. It was practically a hat trick this year. Yay, Nobel laureates for Britain. We can't just hide in our labs anymore. We are a voting bloc. We want to send a message to politicians that if they persist in their idea of dismantling UK science, there will be a political price to pay. We will go and vote for that. We'll vote them right out. So I don't want to be completely negative. This is also about celebrating science. We're all here to celebrate science, to show the Treasury that we think it's important fiscally, culturally, and in many other ways. To that effect, we have a really, really great lineup of speakers. We have dignitaries, we have people from patient advocacy groups, we have science comedians, who I hope will entertain you. And then we will also have my lovely assistant, Dr. Evan Harris, leading us in a few chants. And we're also going to give you the outtakes of some of the placard slogans that didn't make the cut, but were quite funny. So for now, let's get the ball rolling. We're going to do something. Science is vital.